He can move mountains.
Good morning, people of God. You're welcome to Gateway to Life. This is Minister Bridget Ogbeifun. I guess I should say Happy New Year, because this is my first time of appearing since the beginning of the year. I know that God is such a wonderful God, and He has not repented from being who He is. And you know what I'm talking about? He's that person that gives you joy. He's the only one, you know, that gives you a reason to keep living. And I'm so excited that I am connected to this God. You see, I just said I should say Happy New Year. God has been so good. You know, the devil is such a nasty liar. He comes with all sort of things, you know, just to discourage us, you know, from going on, you know, in this race. But the truth is that even before it began, he already failed. And it will remain a failure. Saying that, I want us to just go into, you know, a moment of prayer this morning. And I know that God will be glorified even through His word today. Let's just pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you because you are a faithful God. I thank you because you are the God that cannot fail. You cannot change. Nothing can change you. Rather, you change all things. And for this reason, I am so grateful. And I say, Lord, be exalted in the name of Jesus. Lord, as you use me as your mouthpiece one more time, as we go into your word this morning, Lord, I ask that you take absolute control over what we'll be discussing this morning in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, illuminate the hearts of the hearers, oh God. Illuminate my heart, oh God, through your word today in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, because we know all will be to the glory of your name. For I have prayed in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Yeah, people of God, you're welcome one more time to Gateway to Life. I am so grateful to God. You know, God has been so good, and I am thankful because I have life. I am thankful because God has sustained me. And I know you are thankful too. I know that the enemy may have tried one or two things here and there just to make sure that you stop existing. But God has been on our side. The Bible says that if not God who has been on our side, I'm paraphrasing. It says that when the enemy came, what would we have done? But God is our defense, and He will continue to be our defense. He will continue to be that unquestionable rescuer, unquestionable God. Hallelujah. And I want you to know that 2015 is that glorious year that God has set aside to beautify you. It doesn't matter what it has been in the years past. Even the few months that you have spent in the year, it doesn't matter what it seems like. But I have come to assure you that God has set aside 2015 just to advertise His glory through your life. Just to tell the world that He chooses to do what He wants with who He wants. And nobody can question Him. Hallelujah. And I want you to be positive even as we go furthermore into the year. Be positive. Be optimistic. Know that God has something good in store for you. Know that God has a good plan for you. Know that God desires that the best happen. Even if the devil tries to fight it, keep going. And having said all that, I want to introduce us to the message that we have for this morning. I titled it, Stand Your Ground. Amen, people. Stand your ground. And before I go into it, I want us to just take the text for the morning, and then we will go into what we have for today. The topic says, Stand Your Ground. And I took my text, or rather, we'll be taking the text from Hebrews chapter 10. Hebrews chapter 10, beginning from verse 35 to 39. Let's see what the Bible says. Hallelujah. It says, Therefore, do not cast away your confidence, which has great reward. For you have need of endurance, so that after you have done the will of God, you may receive the promise. For yet, it says, so that after you have done the will of God, you may receive the promise. For yet a little while, and he who is coming will come and will not tarry. Now the just shall live by faith. But if anyone draws back, hallelujah, my soul has no pleasure in him. But we are not of those who draw back to perdition, but of those who believe to the saving of the soul. Stand your ground. The Bible says we are not of those who draw back. It says, but of those who believe to the saving of the soul. I want to read that same scripture in another, in the King James version of the scripture. Let's see if we will pick any difference. It says, cast not away therefore your confidence, which hath great recompense of reward. For ye have need of patience, hallelujah, that after ye have done the will of God, ye might receive the promise. For yet a little while, and he that shall come will come, and will not tarry. Now the just shall live by faith. But if any man draw back, my soul shall have no pleasure in him. But we are not of them who draw back unto perdition, but of them that believe to the saving of the soul. I have come this morning, people of God, to encourage you to stand your ground in Christ, to take your root in Christ. It is not a time for you and I to draw back or to chicken out, because this race that we have been called to run is an everlasting war. The Bible says that we set aside those weights that easily beset us. We run with focus the race that is set ahead of us. And so I came up with stand your ground. You know, I was taking out time, you know, to study a law that is implemented in America. Some states in America practice it. And it's called this stand your ground. You know that law, what it's simply talking about is that an individual has no right or has no reason to retreat from a place that he or she is authorized to be in. And when that individual is standing in that place when he or she is authorized to be in, and somebody else or something else poses a threat to them or a perceived threat on their life, the law permits them to use any level of force to defend themselves. Even if this level of force is lethal, that is to say, if this level of force they apply may even lead to the death of the person that is posing that threat on their life, the law covers them. If you kill in that instance, you will not be termed a murderer. The law of stand your ground covers such individuals. You know, I have had reason to follow one or two cases, you know, and I was so keen. I wanted to know what the outcome of the result would be, because as far as I'm concerned, I felt it was murder. But lo and behold, in the end of the case, it says, nope, it's not murder, it's self-defense. Why? Because a law stands in place that gives you the authority to do that. And then I said to myself, if humans could put down such laws, if humans could make such provisions, how much more the God that we serve? How much more the Word of God? You see, but the problem we have is that many of us do not follow the Word of God. We do not understand the authority that we have been given through the Spirit. And so we are tossed here and there by every wind of doctrine. And so we are chased all about the place like chaff. But I've come to challenge you this morning. Stand your ground. There are provisions for you in the Word of God. It is not a time to be lily-livered. It is not a time to chicken out. It is not a time to sink in and be looking for pity party. It is not a time for you to dwell in the things that went wrong in your life or the things that didn't happen the way you wanted them to be. Stand your ground. Pick up yourself from the dust and begin to walk in the path that God has called you to walk in. You know, God has a way of taking people, different people, through different life experiences. These experiences may not feel good. Hallelujah. All things may not feel good. Hear me this morning. But all things work together for good for them that love the Lord. You may be going through things that even you yourself cannot believe yourself. You can't believe such things could happen to you. But I tell you, God has a way of allowing things to come to sharpen us, to clean us up, to arrange us, to set us up for an explosive miracle ahead. But you see, the mistake we made, you know, I was quoting the American law of stand your ground. It says that you do not have to flee from a place that you are authorized to be in. The same thing, you do not have to give up your walk with Christ just because one or two threats come in your way, just because life has thrown one or two things, unpleasant things at you. People of God, in recent times, I have come to understand that God is perfect in himself. He is the will within the will. He is the unquestionable God. He is the one who has power in himself to make and unmake if need be. He is God. If you choose to throw in the towel, if you choose to give up, if you choose to say, look, this is too hard, I can't take it anymore. I'm not prospering in all aspects of life. My job is not the way it should be. I don't have a good job. My marriage is not working. My children are not working the way I want them to be, to do. I don't have nice people around me. Everybody seems to be against me. All the bad things, everything seems to be happening to me except good things. If you choose, because of all these reasons, to give up, God still remains God. Hallelujah. Have you thought about that? God still remains God. It doesn't change him. I have heard of people, because they went through trying times in life, they walk out on God and they tell God, go your way and let me go my way. Hey, God still remains God. Even if you choose to stop serving him this minute as I speak, God will still remain God. And tell you what, a million, billions, uncountable number of people are out there giving him unadulterated worship. And hence I've come to tell you this morning, stand your ground in Christ. Be relevant in the body of Christ. Plug yourself into that source. The scripture where we read, he said, you have need of patience. He said, after you have done the will of God, so that you will be able to receive the promise. And talking about this, a very important point that we will dwell on, it's going to take a while, is patience. When you are going through what you go through, patience is an important virtue. You know, when you ask people ordinarily what patience is holding on Patience is waiting. Patience is enduring. I agree with you. Patience is waiting without complaint. My concern is not really on the waiting aspect. My concern is what you do while you are waiting. Where we read, it says there's a need for patience so that you will receive the promise after you have done the will of God. God will not tarry. He is always on time. But the problem is that we try to cage him. We try to put him into our own human timing. But friends, God is God by himself. God is God alone. He knows the timing. He moves when he wants to move. He does his things when he wants to do them. You cannot cajole God. You can't change him from who he is. And so I've come to tell you this morning, do not buy the lie of the devil. Don't let him feel that you will rot in that situation you are in. Don't let him feel that, don't let him succeed in planting it into you that this situation that you are going through right now, no matter what it is, don't let him succeed in telling you that it has come to destroy you, because it is not the truth. But when you know who you are, and you know whose you are, and you know that God will not allow you go through things that you are unable to bear, then you will put your foot down and then you will stand your ground in Christ. You know, I was talking to us in recent times, I've come to appreciate the man called Job. I don't think any human in the face of the earth would experience more than what Job went through. Oh, I cannot continue but to mention it. The Bible says that in all these things, Job sinned not. Job did not waver. Job stood his ground in Christ. You know, I look at some of us Christians and the best I can do is just smile. Sometimes we read the scriptures and you don't really understand what they mean until you go through certain experiences. It may be that experience you are going through right now. God does not send evil. There's no evil in God, but he may permit certain things, because there's something he wants to complete in you. He permitted what happened to Job because he wanted his latter end to be greater. He permitted what happened to David when David, a man of war, left his place and started doing the things he should not do. He allowed him to go through when David had to be running in the wilderness and all that because his son was chasing him and after his life. And then he began to write the book of Psalms. When God allowed him to go through that trauma, it's because God was shaping him, making him, molding him to the place where he could be called the man after God's heart. So relax yourself. You may be sick in your body. You have prayed and prayed and prayed, and nothing seemed to be happening. It has not come to destroy you, but rather, God has allowed it so that you'll be able to move to the next phase that he has in store for you. But what you have to do, don't give up. Don't throw in the towel. Stand your ground. Maintain your stand. Continue to confess the word of God. Continue to say what his word says. Continue to walk in line with what his word says. Begin to confess it. I feel weak in my body, but I am made perfect in Christ. My weakness is made perfect in Christ. Begin to confess the word of God. I may not have money. My job is not where it's supposed to be. Continue to confess the word of God, knowing that there is a law that covers you. Hallelujah. Knowing there's a force that covers you. That force is in the name of Jesus. You have been bought with the redemptive blood of Christ. You cannot afford to chicken out. Do not cast away your confidence. Do not give up. It don't matter what is going on right now. Because that is the aim of the devil. When it comes to attack, it's so that he can cause you to waver. So that he can cause you to give up on this God. So that he can cause you to become double-minded. And you know what the Bible says? It says a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. A double-minded man is just like feather in the wind. It could be blown anywhere. And then he begins to suggest all manner of thoughts into you. Mind you, I am not saying going through trying times is easy. Far from it. I am talking out of experience. It is not easy to hold on at that time you are going through a difficult situation. But I tell you, your root in Christ is what will see you through. That even in the midst of the crisis, even in the midst of the pain, even in the midst of that rejection, even in the midst of that loss, even in the midst of that situation where you feel that you are failed, your root in Christ is what will carry you through. Hence, there's a need for you to deliberately put your foot down and stand your ground. I have come this far. I cannot go back. That should be your motto. That should be your continual confession. Like Job did. For yet in a little while, he who is coming will come and will not tarry. Now the just shall live by faith. But if anyone draws back, he says, my soul has no pleasure in him. But we are not of them that draw back. Amen. If you're hearing the sound of my voice this morning, or you're watching me on your television set, we are not of them that draw back. The Lord made that promise. He said, I will be with you. He says, when trying times come, when difficult times come, when situations come that you can't, nobody can really understand how you feel. He says, I will be with you. When such situation come, he says, when you pass through waters, I will be. He did not say if. It means at one point in time or the other in our lives, we will face trying times. We will face difficult situations. We will face threat from the enemy. We will face threat from the enemies. But the Bible says, I will be with you. When you allow this to take root in you, when you allow this word to get a good hold of you, then nothing will be able to force you to draw back. I came here this morning to say, God has a reason why he has brought you into existence to experience what you are experiencing at this time, because he wants to glorify himself. You cannot afford to give up. There is a power in you that no force can take. Amen. That is what the devil is after. There is a power in you that no force can take. And the devil knows it. He knows you carry on your inside something that he himself cannot withstand. And so he's throwing all kind of things, all bricks, all manner of things at you, just to let you lose hold of that fact. But I once read it in one book. The Bible says that when life throws those bricks at you, pick up the bricks and begin to build. Set them on one another and begin to build. You lose your job. Take it. Yes, it wouldn't feel good. But what is the lesson God wants you to learn from it? Pick up the lesson. Pick up yourself from the dust and move on. You are sick in your body. This particular sickness keeps coming over and over again. What does God want you to learn from it? I am not saying, don't get me wrong, that God will send sicknesses at you just for you to learn a lesson. But what I'm saying, God allows certain situations, certain things, because he wants you to learn for yourself who he is. God did not send the sicknesses and all the losses that Job experienced, but he allowed it. And the end, the Bible says the latter end of Job superseded the former. And so don't think, you know, some of us have the tendency, the year has just begun. We started the year with enthusiasm. We started the year being very, very optimistic, hoping that things will work out. Oh, this is a new year. Some of us even write down the things we want God to do for us. And then the year has gone, you know, almost quarter of the year is gone. And it seems nothing is happening. And there's a possibility that you begin to lose hope and begin to, you want a chicken and come to tell you. Do not put your hope or your sight on the things around you. Stand your ground in Christ and watch him supernaturally turn things around for you. There is something that I've come to believe. No matter what I go through in life, I look at the situation and I tell it, I said, you will come to pass. The Bible says, and it came to pass. And I speak to every situation. I want to give that to you this morning. Look at that situation in the face and say, you will come to pass. It don't matter how long or how deep or how hard it is biting. You will come to pass. Friends, I will be drawing the curtain at this point. Next week, we will come back to continue from where we stop. I want to leave you with this word. The plan, the thoughts that God has towards you, they are thoughts of good and not of evil. God will never take pleasure in seeing you in pain. God loves you and he has good plans for you. Just open your arms. Look away from the circumstances around you. Look away from the reports and embrace this God. And you will experience a supernatural turnaround. I will not end this program without saying a big thank you to Pastor Patricia Dino. She stood the fourth when I was not here, and I really appreciate. I also want to say thank you to Pastor Natalie Akindele, because at a point in time, she too came up. But we thank God for these vessels that God has. I trust that you enjoy them, and I know that God will continue to take them from glory to glory. The ministry that God has placed in their hand, he will continue to expand that ministry. And until I come your way next week to continue on what we have started, don't forget, stand your ground in Christ. And above all, you are a champion and you are born to rule and reign in life. Thank you.
He can move mountains. Keep me in the